last match, let's fight against someone who is worthy of the Peace Fleet. Before we get crazy with whatever that's supposed to be, let's go against those two Battle Stars. Or not Bay Stars is what I mean. Is what I mean. Okay. Doing good. Especially since I haven't, especially considering I haven't played through the tutorial or the single player. But no, the game, while complicated, is easy to pick up, and then it's hard to master. And if you haven't played tons of these games, like for example, Sunrider is insane compared to this. But Sunrider Mesoarcadius is a bit unbalanced, so I want you to go all the way in the back, because you can just launch missiles like there's no tomorrow. There might not be. Okay. Curve out like that, and then turn inwards. Again, turn out like that. Turn inwards. I guess you're going to go on the right. And provide flag suppression. And you're also going to go low.
And you're launching alert vipers.
Everything?
Yes, sir.
We'll find out what raptors are. You're fine. In turn.
Waiting for the roar of that first salvo.
Now they collide. So obviously what I have you do. Actually, do I have you lower? Still collision. That's not good. Okay, never mind.
Yes, Commander.
Actually, two Battle Stars squadrons protect the Battle Stars. Might that be defended from as well? Oh, whoops. Oh, is that a gunship? And you can board with it, of course you can. And you can boost firewalls. Oh, jeez. And you got... It's a gunship. I didn't know. Aren't you the dropship? Boost the firewalls at the front. Seemingly want to kill my freaking ranger again. What do they have against archers? Maybe they don't like snipers in their society. I don't know. Oh, that's
dangerous.
Watch your intervals, people.
Weapons free and by the numbers, folks.
What's up? Our walls boosted, alright. That is a lot of junk! Okay, now we're going to need to slow down. Oh. turn inward. Once they have set, whilst they're going fall, we turn inward on them. We turn inward on each other. You shuffle a bit. You need to get back in the fold. Oh, wow, you're in a new belly. In turn.
Fight colors warmed up and preparing solutions.
Have port clearance, don't attack. Priority 1 is in safe hands.
Oh, the shinshu they're going after. They realize that this guy wasn't going their own. Smart AI, smart. So now you go back on your own. You know, kind of get the AI to get into a fatal funnel here. Move up so you can freaking spam bullets in the enemy's general direction.
On it, Commander.
Two are going to get in. No! Much will he ever do? Get down low for this guy. Oh yeah, you're on the south flank. Oh yeah, this is going to be glorious. Are we seeing a Battlestar? Oh no, that's a refinery. Or the terrain, I think.
On it, Commander.
And you go over here to protect these flanks, and you go 100% defense. Get more and turn. Oh, there's more board.
Missiles incoming!
Come on!
Hey, time for stuff to get real. Alright, here we go. You need to get into the action now that they have completely forgotten about your existence. Thankfully, you also go really high. Spam missiles. Spam them all. Snipe them all. Snipe you. Snipe you because you're probably just going to get murdered
missiles
by bullets.
Missiles on their way.
By cannon bullets, also known as shields. Cannon shields. Oh, you are so dead. Do you understand how dead you are? I mean, like, seriously. I don't think you can comprehend how dead you are. And actually, everyone that got missiles, fire the freaking Battlestar. I want it not to exist anymore. Fight missiles with missiles. Okay, you need to get in range and fight some side flak. You need to probably deploy plating on you.
Launching drones.
Turn.
Reloading.
Got one!
Jupiter is taking
what did you
in.
Hear? Nothing but rain. Another Battlestar! Okay, you need to shuffle and get in their rears. I don't think it matters. Actually, yes, it does matter. Not for these guys, I don't know. Okay, you need to you're going to duel. Have fun with that. You're also going to missile them. You're going to focus all of your fires onto that guy's face. You're going to also slow down. You are having issues. Moving part of the stronger is what I'm taking that at. Oh, I'll take out you because you got Ingle on them. Whatever raptor we got, we need a border on people. Can't do that. No, can do, sir. Well, I guess I'm there.
A Battlestar is being hacked. Jupiter is taking damage.
Oh, you're smoking now! Keep on niching! Actually, it's gonna die from our team next turn, so go ahead and just unload that one now. Keep attacking from the back. They never suspect a thing! Now, you're focusing firing, you're focusing firing, you're focusing firing. Enter.
We're
gonna blow up.
Jupiter
is taking a pounding. You're done. Oh well, you go. Battlestar is coming up. Baystars go when they go, don't they? Keep moving, and I'll start angling. Until one turn to reload. Oh yes, got munitions to you. Really slow down. Actually, shuffle. Like, you really don't want me to hit you. You're probably smart.
On it, Commander.
I don't want that much. I don't want that much turn. Oh, we're losing Marines. That is my good.
Missile tubes prepped.
Smoke them if you got them. That gave us more an attack. And turn.
Jupiter is taking damage.
Are you going? You're going! You're gone! Oh, jeez! Oh, you're... Oh, we got you mid-explosion. Good. Okay, you turn like this. Raise higher. Jupiter's pounding, but it's winning. Although the boarding party is what I'm fearing. It's not good. Okay, turn. And then you will spend missiles at someone or another. I am not quite sure. I guess you. If you got on that guy, make him suffer.
Repel the border. Keep them out of the CIC.
Yeah, I've got to dispel quick.
Attempting to flush network.
Are you done? You're done. Gotta end it now, or else we'll lose a Jupiter.
Great. White party's king strength. Uh-oh.
We might. Oh, we can't move it anymore. Great. Advance! Take him out so we don't lose a ship!
We need to go here and start shooting people.
You need to do some semblance of something.
Launching drones.
Okay, you're running low.
So say we all.
This far? Dig him out. Fire control offline. Oh, that's not good. And turn.
Nothing but the rain.
Jupiter is taking damage.
Target is 2-4 by 9-5.
Hopefully restocking means people too, or else this is gonna suck. I mean, it's kinda sucking for the Jupiter already, but you get the idea. Guided missiles.
Understood.
Away. Launch all of them. Launch all of them. And then we'll reload you. My plan is working perfectly. Yay! You're out. And turn.
Jupiter is taking damage.
Reaching. Bingo fuel.
Jupiter might go. If it doesn't, if it doesn't go, we'll need to purge it of Cylons at this point. Launch missiles. You don't got missiles. You can't. Fantastic. Making so far. You need to launch. We're in range.
Supply raptors are ready.
Entered.
We've got them now.
We got them before the Jupiter went down. Yeah! Saved by the bell means just saved. Is she successful without loss? Three in a row, and we beat the high, and we beat the, not the hardest, the next hardest. Cylons. Yay! So we know we can take on the best. I mean, that strategy works, having two battle stars essentially be on the flanks of a gunship and just have them move up with a battle star. I mean, they could move up right next to each other and have the battle stars turn in. And that just works great. And having people be on the sides to kind of funnel the Cylons to side to side. Remember, you know, Cylons AI could be weird sometimes, so it can, you know, go into, it can sometimes be overly simple to, I want to kill you. You are not the weakest you're not the weakest threat. You are not the most unarmed civilian to ever exist. I will now go after the, the more serious threat, kind of thing. What do I think of this game? How much is it normally? Hold on. Gotta wake up the surface. It is... The game itself is... $39.98 normally. It is totally worth it. At least... it's totally worth it at least from Skirmish. The skirmish mode is amazing. It's not the most complicated thing to ever exist. Like, it's not a real-time strategy games. It's not real-time strategy games or real-time tactical games. Skirmish mode, but for a turn-based tactical game, for a turn-based strategy game where you're lucky to have one at all, it's outstanding. I love it. And that's without considering the campaigns. And the game is totally, and the, and overall, if you get the Season 1 bundle, especially if you get it for $43, it's totally worth it for $43. I love it. I love this game. And all the information I know comes from all the information I know of BioStar comes from the first hour of the miniseries, more or less. I watched a bit more than that, but you get the idea. And watching lore and watching the few lore videos on the few channels on YouTube that have Battlestar Galactica lore, like Space Talk, like lore Reloaded, and stuff like that. But anyway, so yeah, Battlestar Galactica is amazing. And if you are a turn-based strategy fan, you should definitely check this out. If you are a space fan, a big spaceship combat fan, you should check this out. If you are a Battlestar Galactica fan, you already knew this, but you should check it out. The only people I don't recommend this to, if you don't like games which... If you don't like strategy games which are less action-y, as in if you play, for example, real-time tactical games which are constant action, which are this, but it's hectic. This is more take your time. It's a space battle. It's a turn-based space battle. So take your time. Choose your options. Mull over your options. And you get the idea. Whereas in, for example, Company Heroes or Men of War, where it's just insanity. And yeah. And you can play this like a real-time strategy game too, where you just don't take time in turns. You go from ship to ship to ship, going as fast as possible. Although you can always just, you know, play it normally, but, you know, you can always play it fast if you want to. And the only real slow bit of the game is really just the beginning of the match. And even then, it's only like, what, three turns, and you're needing to be strategic in those turns. You're needing to be thinking tactically in those turns, or else you will probably not do so well at the end, because of how fast battles are. It could be that I'm just wiping out the Cylons. I'm playing amazingly. This is like my first time, and I'm just wiping out Cylons, meaning the match is quicker. In skirmish anyway, but, you know, but if you don't wipe out the Cylons nearly as quickly, I would say that the match would go on longer, with the battle of the health bars, pretty much. But yeah, but no, I mean, even like this, because to me, this is hectic. Well, you know, it's amazing. Like, I love this just as much as I love Sunrider. Sunrider for me was the best turn-based strategy game. Chip turn-based strategy game. This is better. You know, because the graphics are there, the skirmish is easily available. You're not just, you know, it's not just mechs in space. It's, you know, normal ships. It's on it's 3D, and just overall, I love this more than Sunrider. And overall, it should be checked out by everyone. I would say, yeah, this is a perfect game. It does what it's trying to do. It is a Battlestar Galactica game in an era in which you haven't seen yet in the shows. And yeah, and it's just overall trying to be a really good 3D turn-based ship game, big ship game, or turn-based strategy big ship game, and it succeeds in everything. Could there be more options or skirmish? Yes. Does there need to be? Not really. And I don't know what the campaign's about. But yeah. I mean, but it doesn't quite matter to me either. To me, campaigns and strategy games are cool to have, but I want me my skirmish. Like, I do not like single player, you know, basically campaign only strategy games. I just don't like them. I prefer having a skirmish. I would much rather have a skirmish only strategy game than a campaign only strategy game. But I love having both. But anyway, so yeah, that'd be it for this video. Thanks for watching. And this game is most definitely totally worth it. Everyone should check it out unless you really, 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 really don't like slow-paced tactical games. And if you haven't ever tried one before, Battlestar Galactica is definitely a game to check out. You saw me go from my desktop, clicking on the icon, having just installed it, and then, you know, gluing up a skirmish match, and then just being at home. I mean, yes, this is coming from someone who has played tons of, you know, tons of Slytherin games to begin with, and then tons of strategy games of all of the varieties, from real-time to real-time tactical, to 4X, to turn-based strategy, to 3D strategy games, and to 3D strategy games, and etc. And I just felt right at home. But yeah, I mean, to a first player, I would definitely recommend checking out the campaign first. It probably explains all you need to know, but it's complex, but it's not complicated. You get in it, and you know exactly what everything does. You don't have to look up a out-of-game chart in order to understand what in the world's going on. But yeah, alright, anyway, that'd be it for this video, thanks for watching. We appreciate you watching watching these videos. Oh jeez. These videos, your results may welcome you to subscribe to, forget about that last bit. Also, don't forget to check out their story part of their verse. You can check that out in the description, below the playlist, below the line. You'll find the Google Drive to the lore files of the Derverse, a sci-fi setting I've been working on since I was very little, and was the universe I played in when I was a kid. You can see the lore files from the timeline to bios. And then you can also check out the first draft of my first book, which I now just completed the third story or chapter, and I kind of need to upload that, and I kind of need to upload my second book, which is the space version, which is not the space version, jeez, which is the Space Golden Era, taking place in the year 2530, where humanity has expanded throughout the entirety of the Orion Arm. And has 60 years ago met its first extraterrestrial race, the Shadow People. When they met them, they ran into the Shadow People's mortal enemy, the Illuminari. The Illuminari are pretty much a colonist of the Shadow People, and by the way, Shadow People are essentially like stick figures made out of just darkness who live in black holes. The Illuminari come from white holes. And after this devastating war, and this is 60 years after the devastating war, where he followed Dirschbline, his wife and friends, and the crew of the GBSS Dirster, a destroyer class. I need to think of a word for space and or sea mean battle tank, because that's what it is. Essentially, it is a cruiser and a destroyer all wrapped up in one. Includes, and is also a bit of a carrier with the ability to hold an army inside. The ship is 500 meters long, 700 meters wide, and 300 meters tall, and is in the shape of a gigantic D, a navy blue D. And D as in the letter, of course, capital D. It has railguns and lasers, including a tertiary laser, which pops out of the back and, well, is a typical one-shot weapon. And yeah. And the book... I'm on the second episode, so I don't know what the book's about yet, but the book is pretty much just going to be their adventures, where they just explore, not only do they explore the human side of the galaxy, the Orion Arm, but also humans are exploring the rest of the galaxy, which is home to all sorts of life. So it's your classical sci-fi story mixed with very modern ones like Battlestar Galactica. Essentially. So yeah, and also humans aren't totally united. There are the Reds, space commie fascists, which evolved from the nation of, well, the Grand Union of the Eastern Coalition, the Union before the Union of Russia and China. After the fall, they nuked their capitals and escaped into space, thus creating the Reds, who were born from genetic manipulation. And then you got the Changers, which also come from the fall, and they are a race of physical AI. Physical AI machines, meaning that they are like you or me, can only interact with technology by tapping on it or plugging into it. They are not like Watch, who is a digital AI who just lives in the internet. But anyway, so yeah, and there are two Reds, two twins, in command roles on the Thirster, and one Changer, one Shell person, and of course their squad, which at the beginning of the book is the same as it was in my first book in the Golden Era, but not because it's the only people their squad hangs around with. There have been tons of squads throughout the history of their story. It's just I wanted to start the book with them. Alright, so anyway, that'd be it for today. And now I need to definitely freaking upload that book. Alright, so that'd be it for today. Thanks for watching. And I guess, see you in a second.